Now that we've run the model and we know what we're going to be looking for, I'm going to walk you through the main points of this output. The first thing I look at is record number 3, which is going to show us what type of forest model was it. It's a classification since we're trying to classify this non-binary data. The number of trees, so how many trees did we build in this model? So that ensemble is 500 trees worth. The next thing I look for is record number 4, which is the OOB estimation of the error rate, or the out-of-the-bag estimation error rate. As you can see, this is quite low at 3.5%, and this is that bootstrapping that I mentioned before. Over in options 5 and 6, you can see that classification or confusion matrix, which shows us how many items were predicted correctly within each bucket and were there any trends or not. And overall, you can see that both the bike and the cars were predicted quite well, but the public transportation was a lot worse at 9%. But overall, all of them are under 10%, which I would consider quite good. But again, this is only off the estimation data, so we can definitely go and compare this to then the validation results. What I see in plot number 8 is the percent error for the different number of trees. This is important because on the x-axis we have the different trees. And so as you remember, we put in 500 trees into this model. And as we increase in the number of trees, what does the error occur for all of the different options? For the bike option, for the car option, and the public transportation. As you can see, with no trees, we have very high error rates, obviously. But with more trees, it definitely flatlines at a certain point. And wherever it flatlines, that's typically the most number of trees that are actually needed. But having too many trees in our model that are not actually necessary, it's definitely going to take the model a little bit longer to run. So we typically want to go and remove some of these excess or unnecessary trees in future runs. So maybe I might reduce this to 200 trees to be safe. The last thing I'm looking at is the variable importance plot, which is the exact same thing we saw in the decision tree models before. We're able to see that the drive distance in miles and the age categories are very important in this forest model, but the marital status and gender provide no real help in trying to predict what mode of transportation these employees are going to take to work. And as you can see, this is based off a sign called the mean decrease in Gini, but overall, we're not going to go into that too much. But if you do want to, there are some reading notes that inform you what this Gini coefficient actually means. But overall, the way to interpret this is the higher the values are on the y-axis and further over on the x values, that represents that they are more important to the model than the ones over to the bottom left. So these two are very important. These provide little to no importance at all. So overall, with these results, I'm going to go back up to this OOB estimation of the error rate and this confusion matrix. And I see that we only had an error rate of about 3.5. So I think this model is pretty good. But like I mentioned before, we need to try our model out on a validation data set to determine how well it predicts with independent data.